This is the YGTV News.
Welcome to the YGTV News. These are the main headlines today on Monday, the 8th of July. I'm Giordano Durante. Isola takes on finance and gaming portfolios in ministerial reshuffle. DPC announces plan changes for small boat marina. GSD say Picardo misled Parliament and Gibraltar over Sunborn investment. RGP renews call for information 5 years after Chaima Slim disappearance. And finally, Dartboard charity presentation. Following GSLP by-election candidate Albert Isola's win last week and his swearing in as a minister for the Gibraltar government, the Chief Minister Fabian Picardo this morning announced that Mr. Isola would take over the ministerial portfolio for financial services and gaming. These responsibilities were formerly held by Justice and Education Minister Gilbert Licudi. All other ministerial portfolios are to remain the same. Commenting on the change, the Chief Minister noted that he was delighted to welcome Albert Isola to the Cabinet table this morning, and that the government considers that the result of the by-election was a vote of confidence in its performance in office since they were elected in December 2011. YGTV spoke to Mr. Picardo and to Mr. Isola about the appointment.
Chief Minister, you've assigned the ministerial responsibilities for Albert Isola, who was elected on Friday. Could you explain in more detail what these are?
Well, I've asked Albert to look after financial services, gambling and lotteries. These are really the online gaming portfolio and the financial services portfolio, which previously Mr. Licudi used to look after. And essentially, therefore, this means that Albert is going to be able to use his skills in marketing Gibraltar as a jurisdiction, which he's been doing as a lawyer, in financial services and now gaming as well. Gilbert has done a fantastic job in both of those portfolios. He's added 200 jobs in financial services in barely 18 months, 400 jobs in the online gaming industry, three or four new companies licensed already, and three more on the way. So Albert has a huge standard to meet in order to be able to reach the standard that Gilbert has reached. But I was very keen that Gilbert should be able to concentrate and should have the time to concentrate on the national legislative agenda, because there's a lot in our manifesto that we have to deliver in terms of changes to our laws before the end of the lifetime of this parliament. He's got to deliver two new schools in the upper town, and he's of course leading the interministerial committee on the 700 berth marina. So I wanted him to have the time to concentrate on those issues, although he has already demonstrated that he could have done all of that and the financial services and online gaming portfolio. But given Albert's skill set, I thought that was the best area for him to be assigned.
And what particular skills and experience does Mr. Isola have which will serve him well in this new ministerial portfolio?
Well, you see that with his family, he's built a law firm which has increased in size exponentially in the past 11 years since he left Parliament the last time. So that is the sort of growth that we want to see in Gibraltar PLC. Therefore, marketing Gibraltar outside, in being able to understand the legal and financial issues that arise in respect of the financial services portfolio, the regulatory issues that arise in respect of the gambling and lotteries portfolio. That is the skill set that I've identified he has, and I think the general public really he had when they gave us such massive support at the recent by-election.
Chief Minister, thank you for explaining that.
Thank you.
First Minister Isola, congratulations on your election to Parliament.
Thank you very much.
How do you feel about the ministerial portfolio that you've been given by the Chief Minister this morning?
I'm thrilled, I'm excited, I'm delighted. There are two areas that I'm familiar with, having worked there in the past, so it's nothing new to me. It's almost like a continuation, but with a different responsibility. And frankly, with Gilbert having done what he's done in the last 18 months, where he's increased the complement in terms of marketing, he's really stepped up the marketing drive. He's attracted new business into Gibraltar. He's tackled the issues of tax that are a continuous challenge for GIB. I'm very fortunate to walk into an area where he's already done so much work. And also, additionally, to have him close by and with me in helping me to tackle these issues in the months ahead. With gaming, very much the same. He's been working extremely hard on the consumption tax issues. And again, you know, he's succeeded in bringing, I think it's around four companies already into GIB during the 18 months with the increased employment levels. So it's a hard act to follow, but I know he's going to be close by and available to help and work with me in seeing these things through. So I'm lucky, very lucky.
With gaming in particular, there seem to be certain challenges perhaps for Gibraltar in the future. How are you going to meet those?
Look, whichever sector you look at in Gib, where we're successful, there are challenges. There always are, whether it's financial services, whether it's gaming, whether it's commerce and trade with online shopping. So wherever you go, there are challenges. It's a question of getting together, working through them with some assistance and guidance and help when it's needed, and doing what the right thing for the right reasons. And with the team that Gilbert set up, I'm very confident that we're able to do that.
Are there any particular policies in these areas that you want to push forward?
There are certainly, I expect there'll be a change slightly in terms of how I want to focus things in moving forward, but it's early days yet. I need to listen. I need to learn from the people that are there. There are very good teams in both of these responsibilities. So I wouldn't be jumping in to make any decisions until I've had the benefit of their advice, and obviously talking to Gilbert as well, because he's fully up to speed on all these issues, and I will certainly want to talk to him before I make any decisions. I'm not doing anything quickly, that's for sure.
Isola, thank you for talking to us.
Pleasure. Thank you very much.
The Development and Planning Commission met this morning to discuss the government project for an extensive small boat marina to be built in the harbour next to Coaling Island. Chris Riddell, the project manager, announced that the plans for the wharf at the northern end of the marina had been altered to allow for a wider channel to access the marina. He also explained that a small island would separate the access channel from a special exclusion zone where only sailing and rowing boats would be allowed to navigate. Mr. Riddell said that there would be a 20-metre bathing zone by the shore in the area of the Mediterranean and Galpe rowing clubs. The changes came about, he explained, after he had listened to the concerns presented in representations made by the respective clubs who use the waterfront for various activities. The GSD opposition says it is appalled at the way the government attempted to keep secret the existence of Credit Finance Company Limited, the £289 million investment of what it says was savers' money, made by the Gibraltar Savings Bank, to that company, and the £30 million loan made by that company to Sunborn Gibraltar Limited. The GST says the Chief Minister of Gibraltar has been prepared to mislead both Parliament and the people of Gibraltar to avoid disclosing these facts in the middle of a by-election. This coming Wednesday will mark the 5th anniversary of Chaima Slim's disappearance. Chaima, who is now 24 years old, was last seen walking across the Gibraltar frontier into Spain at around midnight on the 10th of July 2008. The Royal Gibraltar Police continue to carry out inquiries into her whereabouts and periodically review the investigation, and any new potential lines of investigation will be pursued. Any person wishing to provide any information relating to her should telephone the duty officer at police headquarters on telephone number 200 725 00. And finally, the Minister for Sport, Stephen Liaris, this afternoon presented the dartboard used in the final of the Gibraltar Darts Trophy to Trisha Parker, a representative of William Hill Online. The dartboard, which has been autographed by the two finalists, will then be raffled for the William Hill Project Africa. That's YGTV News. We're back tomorrow evening. See you then.